Alright everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how I painted my PSA AK-104. What you're seeing is the pre-painted version, and I have covered the pistol grip, the trigger guard, and the optic. So starting out, I'm doing a base coat of brown and green, and then I'm going to go behind it with some extra add-ons. The style I've chosen is to go with essentially some big stripes, and what that is going to be the macro camouflage, and then I'm going to go behind and give it the micro camouflage. I'll make sure to list all the colors down below that I used. I know everybody's going to ask about it. I'll link whatever they are. I don't remember the names off the top of my head. So like I said, I'm doing a base coat here and I'm opting to do brown and green. And so I'm literally just alternating. I'm touching up the macro camouflage here and I'm about to go behind and I'm going to start on the micro camouflage. So to do the micro camouflage, I'm using a laundry bag. What it's going to do is break up these large colors, and it's going to give it some smaller definition and detail. So where I painted the base colors brown and green, I'm going to alternate and paint the brown base coat with a green top layer and the green base coat with a brown top layer. Here I'm just touching up what I did. So now that I've done the green and the brown, I'm going to contrast and go with a lighter color. And you'll see here it's going to be a lighter tan. And then I'm going to contrast that with a darker color. For the best results, you want to keep the netting close to the gun. That'll give you a better detail. And as you can see right here, it's turning out pretty well. I'll keep touching it up as we go though. Now we're going to start on the other side. Same as before, we're going to do a base coat of brown and green. And then I'm going to use those as my macro colors. And then I'm going to come behind with the micro camouflage of the opposite colors. The thing with spray painting is it does not have to be perfect. Whatever you do, it's probably going to work. It's going to work well for your uses. I mean, nothing has to be perfect and it'll still turn out pretty well. So same as before, I'm laying down the laundry bag and it's going to give you that micro camouflage on top of the macro camouflage. And I'm just alternating the colors with green and brown. And here you see me touching it up a little bit more. I don't want to focus too much on one area, you know, have too much brown, too much green. I want to break it up pretty well. And right there, I was having, you know, a little bit more of what I was going for. Now, lastly, I'm going to hit it with those contrast colors. This is going to be that darker color. And then once I put that down, I'm going to hit it with a lighter color. And it's going to give it a nice camouflage. Now, initially, I put the lighter color on too much, so that's not really a problem. What I'm going to do is go back behind it. I'm just going to hit it with the darker color again, and it's going to fix it perfectly for me. And like I said before, the laundry bag is really bringing out that fine detail, and I think it's looking great.